Hey, what's up, guys? You're listening to the It Takes a Village podcast. I'm Ashley, your host. This is where the struggles are real, the callings are heavy, the kids are sticky. We come together because it takes a village, and this is your tribe. Hey guys, what's up? Happy Wednesday. Today you're just getting me, and I want to share with you something that I just felt called to talk about. Like, it just came to me in my head, and I don't know what it was, but I think it was because I felt like, you know, I couldn't buy a shirt that said the hot mess mom or, like, you know, the helicopter mom, and all these videos go around just categorizing you into, like, this one, like, you are this one thing. And I always felt like I'm not just a single one of those things. I'm a bunch of those things in different ways and at different times. And then also, what we say to ourselves, like what we tell ourselves we are, has so much power on who we actually think we are and what we can do. And so all that said, it caused me to write this blog post that is now live on theashcarol.com and on the Facebook group if you're in the It Takes a Village tribe. I posted it over in there, but in case you haven't seen it, read it, or whatever, I'm going to share it with you guys now. And it's called, What Kind of Mom Are You? So here it goes. I'm not the hot mess mom, the helicopter mom, the crunchy mom, the free range mom, or any random coin mom labels that we have managed to come up with. And before you get all defensive over your mom tribe, hear me out. Being a hot mess mom or a helicopter mom also feels like you have to be those things, or that you couldn't possibly be the on-time mom because your shirt says hot mess mom, and therefore you need to be a hot mess, and most likely you feel like other moms can relate more to that. But here's what I think. We're not any of those. We're the show-up moms. The moms who show up to soccer practice 15 minutes late because work and traffic held us up. The moms who show up when our littles are crying and the third set of sheets need to be changed at 4 a.m. because of the flu. The moms who show up to the bake sale with cookies from Kroger we've put on our own serving plate because we know we can't bake worth a damn. The moms who show up to a 9-to-5 every day because we have bills to pay, health issues to take care of, tuitions to pay, and memories we want to afford to make. We're the moms who show up right when our kids need us most. We're the moms who show up as wives after the kids have long gone to bed. We're the moms who show up even when we don't know how to. We're the moms who show up the best we know how. And we don't want to be any other mom than the mom who's constantly showing up for her kids, our families, our husbands, and our loved ones. It may be half-assed, sleep-deprived, on a bed of kale salad, or in the newest SUV. Despite how it is we show up, we'll do it until we can't anymore. Because that's what we do. We show up. So before you go into Target and feel down and out because you can't relate to any of those cutely, like, labeled shirts that are targeted for a certain set of moms, remember that we're all in this together, that we're all showing up in every way that we know best how to show up, and that that's good enough, and that that's the most important thing about you as a woman, as a mother, as a wife, is that no matter what, I don't know of a single mom who isn't, you know, messing up sometimes, but yet still showing up. And, you know, we still wake up every morning to do the same thing, despite what the day has for us, despite what our kids are going through, what our family is going through. So I hope this was a message of encouragement to you. If you don't feel like you fit in this cookie cutter niche of moms or this group of moms, and you just kind of feel like you can't relate to, you know, one single one, that you can relate to the fact that you show up day in and day out to do the best that you can, and that is enough. So honestly, that's all I have for you guys today. I hope that was encouraging. I hope that you go into the week knowing that you're valued, you're awesome, you are a fierce, strong woman, and I can't wait for you guys to tune in next week where I'm interviewing Lisa Drexman, the founder of Fit for Moms, aka Stroller Strides, Body Back, all those fitness groups that you see and that you know. She's going to be on sharing some awesome tips and some awesome nuggets about how she prioritizes time and all these things. Like, you're really going to want to listen in. So don't forget to subscribe to the podcast on whatever app you're listening to us in. That way you don't miss this next episode. And I will catch you guys next week. See you later.